This is a letter from a caregiver to their beloved patient. Once I was a caregiver for my late husband Nitesh, so it goes like this. Dear Nitesh, our life has changed seemingly from one moment to the next, and it feels as if we are both grappling with how to deal with the cancer diagnosis and how to relate to each other. All of a sudden, I am your caregiver and I want to do whatever it takes to protect you, to comfort you and reassure you, to make your life as healing and stress-free as possible. I want to surround you with love, to listen to you, to laugh and cry with you. I think of my caregiving as an amazing opportunity to show how much I love you. I'm grateful for the gift of being able to take care of you physically and emotionally. There are many practical ways that I can provide support, like help to prepare for medical appointments, to go to you and take notes, organize your medications, keep a calendar of your appointments, provide arrange transportation, run errands, do the household work, provide updates to the family and friends, assist with any paperwork, do research about your cancer, find books that you would find helpful, meditate and exercise together, cook healing meals, plan some vacation trips and whatnot. To be a good caregiver, however, I do need your help as well. To begin, I would like us to figure out who can be a part of our support team. Although I would like to be able to do everything, I know it would jeopardize my health and well-being, which would turn me into an ineffective caregiver. There are many people who love and care about you and about me, and also impacted by your diagnosis. Let's find ways for them to support us both. It will make them feel better to know they are doing something useful for you and reducing the stress for me. For a support team to work, we need to identify what kind of things need to be done. If you really don't know how or what support you need, then please just tell me. It gives us a place to start. We can figure it out together as partners. If you hesitate to ask for anything because you don't want me to burden or make life more difficult for me, please understand that the lack of information is much more stressful and can be overwhelming for me. It would mean that I have to try to second guess how are you feeling or anticipate what you need. As your caregiver, I also need some feedback about what kind of things are working and what is not working. Your needs will change over time and it's important to let me know when they do. Finally, dear Nitesh, we are on a separate journeys and yours is the one I cannot completely understand. There will be times when I am exhausted and confused, angry and upset, frightened or hurt because you are not behaving in ways that I am used to or your body is not responding the ways we want it to be. Don't forget that those are also the moments that speaks to the depth of my love and caring for you. Thank you.